The worst.
GDPG. We're playing Overland. Welcome back.
Welcome back, everybody. So, last we left off, we ran out of gas and got more gas and a new car. And
that was really the plan all along.
Yeah, no, totally.
New car.
So now that we've gone through, so this is the end of the woodlands. At the end of each zone or like main area on the map, we have like an extra challenging section to get across. And so far as I've seen, they've all been the same each time with some minor randomization. So like after the woodlands, there's always these two dumpsters here. So it forces us to get out, move them in order to drive past it.
Oh, boss battle.
Kind of.
Boss puzzle.
On the plus side, we've got a lot of gas just kind of sitting here.
Esteban.
And this guy's not even holding anything. This is best. Oh, no, but I don't have... Oh, I lost my my pallet shield.
Oh, no. Couldn't fit in the car?
Well, it was... I dropped... Oh, hey, all right. Sweet. I got another pallet shield.
Just push the big guy around. The two-headed monster. Just... push him with the wall.
I mean, that's basically what I'm going to do. But I dropped the pallet for gas.
So, I've kept my tactical nerd brain quiet for the most part, but now I
can as I've made horrible decisions.
Well, not even necessarily like that you've made horrible decisions, because I don't know all about the game.
That's
but
fair.
It's more like there's been certain things that I wanted to talk about. Number one, they have for a square grid based game, they have probably my favorite. Ooh, look at all the sound you're making.
It's okay. Yeah, we're basically done.
You got it. I mean, you have to. So, they have one of my favorite forms of tactical movement, and that's granted, your people can move more than one square, but you can move diagonal. And now, normally, I find that moving diagonal and having it still count as one movement is, it solves a lot of issues with your map. And a lot of people would argue, they're like, oh, that should be two squares, and I totally understand. But by allowing you to move diagonal like this, what it does is it prevents characters from players or computers from pigeonholing and basically kiting and making sure that their characters can never be hit. Because if you can always move, like if you move two squares away and they catch up to you two squares away, then you keep circling around, then the person running away can ultimately never be hit.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And so by moving diagonal, they actually fix that, because eventually the person running away is going to run out of room. Now, granted, this isn't a big deal in this type of game, but it's something. So you have multiple options along the way.
Yeah, I'm actually a little surprised that they're telling us some of these. This might be a little new, because normally we only get to see wherever we can drive to. So something else, too, about this, you can see, like, okay, this is a fuel cache, but since it's close to the road, it's high risk. However, it costs less fuel than if it were... farther. I don't have a good comparison other than, well, I guess this kind of works, right? So, like, there could be a car here, but it's closer to the road. It only costs 5 fuel. This is the same, about the same, like, distance in the main road, but it's farther away, so it costs 8.
And that's probably going to be a safer location?
Yeah, there's going to be less monsters there.
Nice.
Or whatever these guys are called.
They have a lot of risk-reward going on.
Absolutely.
That's pretty awesome.
Getting this guy, so we have 3 people. If I get this guy, it's actually kind of pointless unless I'm looking to get rid of one of my guys, because I can only carry 3 people in a car. And I wish so hard, I've tried this, where I've repaired 2 cars and filled them up with gas, and I was like, okay, we're all in cars, maybe we'll leave together. It doesn't work.
Breaking the game barrier, like the wall.
Yeah.
So one question I have is, like, if you had a car that had 4, like, it carried 4 people and it breaks down, you had 4 people, then you have to get in a car that only holds 3. You have to leave one behind.
Yep.
Nice.
Which is, I think is handled shockingly well in this game. It doesn't take much to make that work.
Oh, spider crawler.
This is not a good situation. But basically, like... you have everyone working with you, right? And, you know, everyone's happy and dandy. And say, like, I have to leave someone behind, right? Well, they're not going to know until last minute when everyone ditches them. So you drive off and they're just like, we'll meet again. Or they'll make some kind of like remark, be like, oh, I really liked you guys. Or like, oh, well, we had a good run, I guess. Like, they all have like different reactions to it. And like, that's, it's just simple. You just left them behind and they're like, well, dang it.
That's fair.
I don't know. It's really satisfying to me. It also makes it that much more sad because I'm like, man, I'm sorry.
It's short and sweet rather than long and kind of drawn out.
Ooh, that's a lot of gas. I mean, I came here for gas, but that's a lot of gas.
But now you got no shield.
I'll pick it up.
No push the shield.
Oh, that's right. Those guys move two spots.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
The real challenge begins.
Yes, most definitely. The other thing is fire's creeping, so we can see this is smoking here, which means that the fire is going to spread to these tiles next turn. And it can be a little explosive, like it will burn down cars.
Nice.
Okay, so I need you probably as far away as possible because these guys are going to move too. He's going to attack. I'm going to
pick up a bat and hit him with it.
I could start siphoning from this car. Actually, you know what? You can stay here because you're not going to get hurt. So siphon that gas. Yeah, buddy. I also like that it keeps track of how many miles someone's been with you.
And that's kind of cool.
I think, oh, maybe that's what it is. I think you unlock new skills in some of these characters if they're with you for X amount of days.
So miles, or is it like miles or experience?
Well, we get a calendar marker here too, so I guess it could be either, right? Like maybe a certain amount of miles unlocks some things and then certain amount of days spent with you unlocks other things, because this little calendar is kind of grayed out too, so I wonder.
So this has all been one day so far.
Yeah, I think we're still in the first day, or at least, okay, it's been one day. I think this is day two, and this guy we picked up partway through. So it hasn't been a full 24 hours. This guy, Daryl, has a star, which means we cannot get rid of him. He is our guy.
Interesting. So if the other people get in a car, they can't leave without him?
Correct. I'm pretty sure anyway. It's
a surprise, actually, that they decided to make that matter. Like, it's about this guy's story.
I am a little surprised, too. The interesting bit, too, is that the main character is the least useful. He doesn't have any abilities. Or she. Aww. Sometimes I think it's a she. But yeah, he's just a dude.
It's kind of awesome at the same time.
Something else nice in the UI, by the way.
Whoa. Oh, the fire.
Ooh, yeah. Now you this guy's blocked. Cut off. Something else that's nice is that this end turn button is red whenever I still have actions that I could spend.
Oh, nice.
I don't want to go to any of those spots. This is not happy times.
So, here's the thing about it, too. So, going with action economy. Because mm-hmm. if you're able to kill the spider guy right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it would create more. But at least the guy who's immediately threatening you and up really close to you is no longer a threat. So, yes, you were talking about how it's not necessarily a good idea to attack them and everything. But in this is one of those dire circumstances that you're mentioning before where, yeah, it's actually not a bad idea to attack them if they're that close and they're literally blocking your path. You're about to catch on fire.
Yeah. Okay. This is going to take some finesse.
Clever maneuvering.
Okay, so this guy can be injured there. If I move here...
Can it move diagonal?
It cannot.
Ah, alright.
Which is a pretty big game changer.
So...
Okay, we're just gonna end turn here.
Yep, you're good.
It's... These guys, I think, are really, like... They're dangerous, right, because they can take two actions instead of just one. A lot of these other guys aren't really scary. They're actually pretty easy to avoid because you know that they only move once, and they can't attack after they move. So they're really easy to avoid. Even though, like, when there's, you know, a million of them on the board, it still is stressful. But these fast guys, they change up everything in a way that I think, like, makes the game a lot more challenging, like really fast. But it feels appropriate because they're introduced in the second area. If that makes sense.
No, yeah, I mean, it is. Like, at first, the game is just teaching you simply, hey, there are these creatures. They are going to come after you. And once you learn how to move, maneuver around them, it's not a problem. But then they actually start introducing real threats eventually. And that's pretty smart.
We out of here.
Shh. We no catching on fire. Psh. Not catching on fire. Not this episode.
Not
and
this episode.
And hopefully not the next one. Which is my way of saying time for question of the day. I guess it's on me, isn't it? cool. Actually, let's talk about the new enemy that's introduced. And actually, I mentioned movement before. So, question of the day to you is...
we can even talk about the diagonal movement and how enemies can't, but you can.
Yeah, I was actually...
Okay.
Still. Jeez. All right, so yeah, your players can move diagonal, and they can move two spaces, maybe more depending on how the characters work out. But the enemies not only can only move laterally, I guess is the term, but it's that they can't move diagonal, and for the most part, they only get one movement, right, at least at the beginning. So do you feel that that's too easy, or do you think that that is the right amount of difficulty for the player to be able to learn the game this early on? And finally, what could they do to the monster's movement to make this game more difficult? Because in a tactical game like this, especially grid-based, movement is king.
Absolutely. Well, that's why I like, personally, I was thinking what would happen if there was a monster that had three movement. And that actually, I feel, would almost be unfair.
I could see it.
Because most of our characters can only move two at most.
I mean, it's very possible we get to that point at some time.
Yeah, that's a tricky thing to balance.
Probably just, like, hit it in the head with a stick and try to bolt as soon.
Yeah, oh, no, those are the kinds of guys you would actually want to actively kill.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Right. Oh, man.
Boom.
Well, anyway, thank you for watching, everybody. Be sure to vote if you want to see more Overland or anything else in the voting system, and that'll be what we play next.
Like us. Bye.
Bye, everybody.